$50,000. $50,000. $50,000.
Hi, Al. Hey, I got some great stuff for the April Fool's party tonight. Check it out. Fake vomit. And fake doggy doo-doo.
Humans, they really know how to party.
Well, Jefferson, I've been thinking about it, and I can't go to the party with you.
Why not? Oh, it's the lame April Fool's gags, huh?
Well, that, and I could get killed hanging out with you. See, I don't want to go that way, Jefferson. I want to go the way all Bundys go. I want to hang myself in my own basement by jumping off my workbench. Not that I have it planned out or anything.
But nobody knows who I am, Al. Unless you told.
Why would I do that? Who would I tell?
Paging Mr. Troggett. Paging Mr. Walter Troggett.
Well, that page could have come from anybody.
Mr. Al Bundy, paging Walter Troggett.
What? Hey, Jefferson, I swear I didn't have nothing to do with that.
I see now what I have to do.
But I didn't have nothing to do with that!
You know, you would think after a few years you could count on a friend to take him at his word. But I guess you just never know who you can really trust. A buddy?
That's Bunny! With two ends.
Don't grovel, Al. Look, if you have to say anything, I want you to take a deep breath and tell me who's the best damn April Fooler in the whole world. That's right. April Fool.
What about that guy that came to my store?
Walter Troggett? He's an old friend of the family from D.C. I sent him into your store with that story, Al. And you bought it hook, line, and sinker.
Oh, yeah? Well, you better not use your phone for the next 5 minutes because someone's going to be working on your lines.
Oh, that's a nice try, Al. Come on, let's go to the party.
You mean none of that spy stuff was true?
Oh, come on, Al. If I was really involved in espionage, couldn't I have just made one phone call and had Troggett taken out?
I guess.
Well, then what do you think?
And that's a ground out to third. Oh, my God. Ladies and gentlemen, Walter Troggett just fell to the ground from an upper deck luxury box.